Hi everyone, I'm Maggie of MaggiesBliss.com. So I'm here to discuss a bit more of the energies going on right now with you guys, with the whole collective. So that includes me. Right now, something I forgot to mention last week during the collective oracle reading and Kuan Yin meditation video I did last week with you guys, I'm standing. Because I'm near the water and I just thought it was just the most amazing sound and visual with Cathedral Rock in the background for you guys to receive that beautiful divine feminine grandmother, mother nurturing energy that comes from Cathedral Rock and then the flowing waters as the floods are starting to finally recede here in Sedona, at least for now. So remember, this year is just all about cleansing and clearing the waters as well, as I have mentioned, like last year even. So I brought some cards with me that I pulled for the collective. And before I even pull them up, I'm gonna, because I forgot to mention this before, last week, we are stronger together. That is a strong message that has been coming through. Stronger together. We can do a lot of stuff on our own, yes, and we should when we're guided to. And then we have to remember, let's ask for help when we need it. And know that there are plenty of people that want to support us, help us, and helping us helps them. Just like us helping others helps us. So help when you can. I'm sorry, I don't have my camera stand, so it's a little shaky. Help when you can, and then ask for help when you need it. And be willing to receive, because you're meant to receive. And when someone offers help, oh my gosh, say yes. Especially if it rings true, right? If it feels wrong, then honor that. I respect that. But when they offer and you need what they're offering, say yes. That's the universe answering your request. So that being said, stronger together. Now the waves of ick are kind of still coming in. The energies are rising. The waves of ick are coming and up for release, as they have been for a while, and now it just seems like it's a little more intense. So let me switch hands so they don't get tired. Dropping my cards too. I want to make sure I have everything for you guys. Oh my god, let me just show you. Okay, do you see behind me? 360 degree view of the magic. So a little mini meditation for you guys as you're just looking around behind me. Let me try to get myself out of this. I don't know how to, there's no internet connection, so I'm recording this. I don't know how to flip the camera to show you while I'm still filming with the iPhone camera. So, okay. Now, since the energies that are coming up are for coming up for release, but you know what else is rising? Joy and freedom. And, these words that came through were the pendulum is swinging and it's squaring off. This is important. And I'm trying to remember the words. So we're going to find balance as we rise, right? As we continue to do our work. Right now, what's coming in is a lot of clutter clearing. Clearing out the ick, clearing out your home of any of the stagnant energies, clearing out the electronic ick on your emails, the spam, unsubscribe from things that keep coming at you that you just delete. Just, I spent like 2 hours yesterday and today just trying to clear it out, get clean with everything, even online, get your folders organized, you know, online. But it all does, like, our energy is attached to everything. So clutter clearing is alchemy for the soul. So try that. Pluto is entering Aquarius, right? And because it's entering Aquarius, Pluto's our shadow planet. So there will be some shadow shit that comes up. And a lot of freedom and revolution and coming together in that way is coming up as well. Now, the last time this happened was in 1783, I guess, so a long time ago. It takes over 200 years, like 248 years for Pluto to make it through all the signs in the zodiac. So we're going to have this for the next 20 years, Pluto and Aquarius. A lot of retrogrades are going to make it be felt a teeny bit less, But right now, we're going to feel it for the rest of this year, for sure, because it's not in retrograde. Pluto is not retrograde. And so we're going to feel this Aquarius energy, which is joy, freedom, the element of air. Being defiant is the shadow side of Aquarius, but it blends so perfectly with the fact that they want to be different and step out of the box. And that's what we're doing. So back in the late 1700s, when this occurred, there were a lot of revolutions happening, a lot of things happening out. So go ahead, look up the history. I can't remember all the details, but there was a lot of stuff happening on back then during these energies. So that being said, we're going to have a nice shift for us and a lot of upgrades. Technology upgrades are coming in intense waves, and we need, right, to still remember to get on the land, that we are nature and we need that connection. That being said, let's see. My cards kind of got out of order, so I'm just going to get them in order. So that and there's always a reason for that too, so that's okay. Yeah, that one. Yay, they weren't really that much out of order. So the first card that came in is the Goddess of Beauty. You are a wondrous being of light. There is nothing to change or fix. This is from my angel deck. I don't have the box with me, or I'd show you to see if you're aligning with this artwork. So see what you see here. There is a butterfly at your heart chakra and a high heart. So opening the sacred heart is coming in, but honor your beautiful self. The beauty is all around you. I love that Lakota prayer that I've shared with you guys before. Walk in beauty, sharing beauty, right? But honor the fact that you are beautiful as you are, and you don't need to change anything. You don't need to change anything or fix anything. You're perfect. The universe needs you and the drop that you create within the ocean. We need everyone. Remember what I said? Stronger together, we need everyone, and we need your unique beauty. So whatever that turns out to be in every moment, we're shifting, upgrading, evolving. Then we have Angel of Relaxation coming in to say, let go of desired outcomes. You will get what you want. Throat chakra, rest, relaxation, that beautiful indigo blue color, her third eye. There's so much magic that happens when you surrender and release and let go. When you hold on too tight to what you're wishing for, or you're in fear or worry, you create that. Remember, worry begets more worry. So do your best to do what you're supposed to do, divine guidance and action, and then surrender. And remember, meditate. Because when you meditate and get in higher vibrations, you shift your energy and you shift what's occurring. You're in a state of peace. You've released, you've let go, and you're in a higher vibration to create and make manifest what you desire in a more ease without a lot of physical work. Because we're multidimensional beings. We're not meant to do it all. Next is the Angel of Clearing. Remember what I said about clutter clearing? Your time of waiting and confusion will soon be over. So while you wait for a little bit longer, do some clutter clearing. But this is the angel saying, I'm coming in, I am clearing it out for you. Just like Lord Ganesha, right? Om Gam Ganapataye Namaha, mantra for Lord Ganesha. He comes in and he clears that out, clears the way for your wishes, your intentions. And the angels are with us. They're with us majorly now in this 7 year. Remember, 7 year, all about the ascended masters, the high violet ray and the violet ray energies of the angels and the realms they live in, the higher vibrations. Angel of space clearing, as I mentioned, the space clearing comes in again. This is like a supporting card for the other one. It's time to clear out old negative thoughts and feelings. So don't just work on the physical surrounding areas of your office, your home, and your computers and your emails. Work on inner self. What thoughts are you thinking and feeling? This goes along with the worry begets more worry. Remember, negative thoughts are just creating more negative thoughts. Remember, solutions come to those who are in a more positive, uplifting, pure positive state. Allow yourself to breathe. Get in that meditation. Goddess of Knowledge is also wanting to be shown here. Start to apply what you already know and trust your intuition. There's a lot more than you probably are giving yourself credit for that you know that you either should do or not do. Allow yourself to tune in, listen to your heart, because your heart opens wide. You feel that truthful honesty. Your throat chakra gets activated. What you see, and then what you speak, and then what you feel. Bring it in. You are wiser and more connected than you know. So get into that meditative state, and you'll say, oh yeah. Get out in nature, and you'll walk and be grounded and connected. And you'll say again, oh yeah, that's me. I'm connected. I am one with nature. And then the freedom of truth. This is a 12 card. This is in my unicorn deck. This is a 12 card, which reduces to three. So the Holy Trinity, the three phases of the moon, right? Mother, Father, God, divine feminine, divine masculine in union. The freedom of truth. Communicate honestly. Be who you truly are. Remember, you're beauty. There's nothing to fix. So allow yourself to be who you truly are. We need you and who, what you bring. And what you bring when we're stronger together. You work with others and you bring it, and then faster motion and movement occurs when we can work together, offer our gifts, and then someone else says, yeah, let's work together. And then someone else says, yeah, let's work together. Your soul tribe's ushering in too, so that you can all work together and not just have one person be, right, looked at as, you know, yes, like in a group dynamics, you might need a leader to say, let's do this, but you all join in. You join forces as equals. No one is above you. No one's on a pedestal. We are one together. Okay, last unicorn card that came through for you guys. Oh, it has a squirrel on it too. A squirrel. Oh, I was just looking at the cute squirrel things from yesterday. The woman who took pictures of the squirrel, the beautiful photos. She followed a squirrel for 6 years and grabbed the most amazing photos on Facebook. I saw it and I was showing my daughter. So that's interesting. Squirrels know how to plan and prep ahead, and they work. Creative solutions. They do their balance. 13 is the card. 13 is divine feminine magic ushering in to balance that divine masculine. So we're healthy, we're vibrant, in balance with both of our energies. 13 reduces to 4, which is Gaia. It's earth, it's balance, it's good foundation. Now these creative solutions, I'll show you the card in a second. Think outside the box, just like Aquarius. View things from a higher perspective. Now we're in the Aries sun. We just had an Aries new moon. That portal of the spring equinox is still being felt. And now you can get outside, hopefully, hear the birds stronger and louder, and depending on what area in the world you live in, and get the waters and the red rocks if you're in Sedona or Utah or wherever they have them. They have some red rocks even in Hawaii. Now think outside the box, view things from a higher perspective. You have ideas that no one else has thought of. These ideas can be done in a way that works through you. You have a unique energy soul signature. So allow your creative solutions to come up. So something, when you get into this right mind state and meditation and surrender and let go, the creative solutions come to you more easily, remember? Something is coming to you, and it's going to bring in what you need. Is it financial abundance? Is it more love? Is it more spiritual connection? Is it just excellent health, right? Not just, right? Because that's huge. Whatever it is, the answer's coming to you. So listen to what's coming to you. So I hope that you've enjoyed this awesome on location in Sedona reading. I had to go outside. You know how I roll. I love to be with you guys on the land, whether I have an internet connection or not. And now you get the flow of waters. So remember to step in the water. Enjoy flow. And just flow with that ease of water. Sometimes it's fierce, sometimes it's very still. So allow yourself to be in this flow now, like a gentle river, with ease on this beautiful Saturday. I hope you have an amazing rest of your day. May you always know the peace that dwells within. Namaste. In the name.